Hey everybody, welcome. I'm Suzanne Gunderson from Scream Right Now. I help screenwriters and industry creatives to naturally de-stress and get focused into their creative rhythm and flow, build tremendous confidence, and deepen their emotional worldview into wisdom and truth. That way they can hook every audience. So today's video is a part of my Industry Wisdom Bit series where I'm bringing you professionals in television film to share one bit of golden nugget wisdom or advice that maybe has helped them in their career can help you too. So today we're joined by Christine Eckert. Thank you so much for being here, Christine. Please tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, thank you for having me, Suzanne. I'm Christine Eckert, and I was formerly a unscripted television producer and director for many years. I had shows that were on everything from HBO to HGTV, TLC. And since transitioning to writing full-time, I've written podcast scripts. I just spent the past year helping break story and work on development of certain projects at a LA-based production company. And I have several of my own projects that I'm working on taking out and meeting with executives. So it's always the hustle, as one of my friends likes to say.
Wow, what a range of experience. That's fantastic. And I love watching your posts and seeing what's going on with you as well. So with all of that incredible experience, you must just have, you know, one gem that kind of stands out that can maybe help our audience today. So what do you think you'd like to share?
I thought of many things, but I think the one that stuck out the most to me is pre-writing is really, really essential. And it's something that I don't think especially emerging writers think about enough. I think a lot of writers, especially when they're starting out, they really just want to open Final Draft or whatever program they're using, and they just want to start writing pages. And I've definitely learned that if you don't know the essentials of pre-writing, if you're not doing that work, and by pre-writing, by the way, I mean log lines, synopsis, treatments, outlines, I think it takes you a lot more time to write your stories. And sometimes you just never get them to where they go because you're kind of starting with a false foundation. Mm-hmm. So like one of the things I really want to talk about is log lines, because I've actually seen, I'm pretty active on social media, and I'll see writers in different screenwriting Facebook groups or on Facebook say, oh, I hate log lines, I don't write log lines. But log lines, if you really want to be a professional screenwriter, they're essential. They're your calling card for every project you have. It really should be, I think, the first thing you start with, but you definitely have to learn how to do it. And it is hard to do because you have basically 50 words to, you know, pitch your entire
point
concept.
Across. Yeah, take your point across.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it can be hard and frustrating, and it's a lot of, I've rewritten and rewritten log lines many, many times, but it is a skill set that I think every writer needs. That's the first thing. If you reach out to a producer, you're networking, you meet an executive, they're gonna ask you the log lines for your projects just right off the bat. And if your log lines are messy or the concept is unclear, you're not going to probably get anywhere with them. They're just going to kind of nod and be like, okay, thanks.
Yeah. Sometimes that's all you get is just a log line.
Yeah. I mean, that's a lot of times it is, even if you're cold querying production companies. I mean, that's all you send them is basically the log line. I mean, that's what executives are doing if they're trying to get financing. So that's really essential. And it's also, I think a lot of writers don't realize, if you want to work in the business, again, like figuring out how to write a one pager, figuring out how to write a really tight 5-page treatment or a 10 to 15 page outline. Those are, again, it's all essential to what this industry is, to what the craft is. And I think a lot of writers just kind of put that to the side because it's not as much fun to a lot of writers. I actually enjoy it now. I used to kind of fight it, and it was ironic because when I was working in unscripted television, that was all that we did. We were constantly generating like really big story bible and outlines and all this pre-production material, but I wasn't shifting that to my episodic and narrative storytelling. And once I did that, things really opened up. That's when I started really creating projects that were getting traction and getting work out of it. So I just think it's something that goes in everybody's toolbox, and it's something that everybody needs to start working on. Like
practicing a muscle. It's like building a muscle. You've got to just keep practicing. The pre-writing is so important. Like you say, it's going to give you that foundation to be able to let your story flow. If not, you're just writing in all different kinds of directions and really kind of getting more disciplined, you know, what it is that you're writing. and coming back to those basics again, kind of keeping you focused.
Yeah. And I think sometimes writers look at pre-writing as confined. They feel confined creatively because they just want to let things flow. But it's very freeing to have that roadmap. And I know a lot of writers and who are professional writers, and they approach it in all different ways. There's no one set way to do it. I know some writers who maybe write two or three scenes in the middle of their script, or they'll write the ending, then they'll go back in and write the outline, or they'll write a long treatment. So there's all kinds of ways to approach it. But I think something like that is essential. And my final point in it, if you get hired to work for a company, this past year, I've been very lucky to freelance with this production company. Everything I gave to them was all treatments, small synopsis, like a short synopsis or an outline. I never opened final draft and wrote that kind of script or document because everything they wanted was just story-based.
Wonderful.
So
there you go. There it is. So thank you so much for sharing that. I know it's going to help so many people out there. How can we find out more about what's going on with you today?
If you want to follow me, I'm on Instagram at Christine Eckert, Twitter. It's all my name. So it's all, I think Twitter is at Christine_Eckert. And then I'm also on LinkedIn and Facebook.
We'll have all those links in the description box below. Thank you so much for Christine for joining us today. And thanks everybody for watching. Feel free to pop on over to my website screen right now and download your free ebook copy of 3 Steps to Get Pitch Ready. That way you can get into alignment with your script and hook your audience. Thanks everybody for watching. And we'll see you on the next Industry Wisdom Bits.
Thank you.